Video we have continued with the property of charge. Second, charge is quantized. Charge always travels in a form of quantas. Quanta meaning is nothing but quanta equal to packets. Okay, quanta means packet, means the always the energy transfers one place to another place or one atom to another atom in a form of pockets. So that we can say that always charge travels in a form of integral multiples, that is q equal to plus or minus ne, means n value always it can be minus or plus, but it is completely whole value get transferred. Whole number of electrons gets transferred. Charge never transfer in a form of decimals or in a form of fractions. That's the meaning of charge is quantized. Now here q equal to ne means from this we can understand that one charge consists how many number of electrons. The most important bit. One charge particle, one coulomb of charge consists how many number of electrons that we need to find out. Okay, for example q equal to plus or minus ne. I wanted to find one coulomb of charge consists how many number of electrons. So number n equal to, I am making subject n and q bar e. Since q is one coulomb, I am writing one coulomb. One electron equal to how many? What is the charge of one electron? We know that 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs we can say. Okay, this is the charge of electron. Of course, coulomb get cancer. This can be written as 10 to the power of 19 will come up 10 to the power of 19. Then after 1 by 1.6, it will become 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 number of electrons. Means, one coulomb of charge is equal to how many number of electrons? 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 number of electrons. Is having, that is we will understand from the charges quantized nature only. Next we'll go to the next. Okay, now next property is that charge is additive in nature. What is that additive in nature? Okay, charge is additive in nature means charge always addable or subtractable, like algebraic numbers. When coming to the charge, that is depends on a proton or electron. If in particular area there are n number of electrons are there, plus 1, minus q2, q3, q4, q5, like this some amount of charges are there. The sum of all these algebraic charges is equal to the total charge, which is equal to the located at this area. Means algebraic sum of all these charges which is located at this area is equal to this charge q. Nothing but we can say that summation of q equal to 0. We can write algebraic sum of the all the charges is equal to 0. Or we can write up q equal to q1 minus q2 plus q3 minus q4 plus q5. Okay, so means the sum of all the charges is equal to capital Q. We can say that that is a charge is additive in nature, means charge simply can addable or subtractable like algebraic numbers. That's why we can say that charge is additive in nature. The next most important property is that charge is conserved in nature. What is that? Charge is conserved. We know that we heard this conserved mean already previously, nothing but conservation of energy. Same way, charge is conserved in the sense charge can neither be created nor be destroyed, but it can transfer one atom to another atom. Charge can neither be created nor be destroyed, but it can transform one form to another form. That means we can understand simply, if two electrons and one electron and one positron, one electron and positron if you add it, you will get gamma is a radiation in a form of, this is a gamma. Gamma gives the radiation. Okay, this is gives the annihilation product, nothing but destruction product. It is a destruction, annihilation. Next, in a case of production, if you take heavy metal, any heavy metal if you are taking, okay, like platinum or something, plus 2 gamma if you are adding, this gives that is releasing of positron and electron. This gives the pair of product. Means in this universe, charge always balances. Okay, that means we can say that charge is conserved. Charge can neither be created nor be destroyed. Okay, never be destroyed by anyone. That's why in annihilation, destruction product also, positron and electron arrival that produces the gamma, nothing but radiation you will get. And in a case of pair of production also, heavy metal if you are taking with the gamma rays, then it produces positron and electron. This is the property of charge is conserved in nature. Okay, nothing but if you are taking neutron also, neutron when it gets disintegrated, it produces proton and electron. Okay, in this case also, charge is conserved in nature, we can say that. Okay, pause. Charging by different methods. Till now we were discussing about the properties of charge. Now, how a body or a substance, an object gets charged? We have three methods of charging. That is, one is friction, the other one is by conduction. One more important method is that by induction. Now, friction, charging by friction. We know that we are studying from our childhood classes also that if any two objects get rubbed each other, there is an exchange of electrons will take place. Therefore, the two bodies will become charged. In the same way, a glass rod with silk cloth, if you rub, then silk cloth will get negative charge and glass rod will get positive charge. Means that glass rod, when you are rubbing, before it was neutral body, and when you are rubbing with a silk cloth, this is also silk cloth, is also neutral body, but after rubbing only, silk cloth become negatively charged and glass rod will get positively charged. Okay, so that means this is happened by the after rubbing, that is nothing but due to the friction. Not only this, if you take up, this is a glass rod, this is a silk cloth. Coming to the ebonite rod and fur cloth. Okay, when ebonite rod and fur cloth, if you rub, fur cloth is in the sense any cat's skin or any animal skin, like old type of cloth if you take, that if you are rubbing any metallic rod, like ebonite rod, if you rub with each other, and fur cloth will get positively charged, and ebonite rod will get negatively charged. This is, we know very clearly, by friction. Even when you rub a comb with your dry hair and kept near the any dust particles, then the dust particles is attracting towards the comb. That means, here before it was not, after rubbing only it is happening. Then what is the difference? Because of friction it is happened. Means because of friction something change has come. The something change is nothing but there is a charge has generated. Due to generation of the charge from the first property, it is attracting neutral bodies. A charged body can attract neutral bodies also. Okay, so therefore a comb is attracting dust particles. A scale also dries. A scale, when you rub with the dry air, then it is also attract dust particles when you are keeping near the dust particles. So this is all happened by the friction method. We can generate the charge. We know that we might have seen many of the times in the sky when there was a rainy time. Okay, two clouds collide each other. Means before the clouds, while it is traveling, it was rubbed. When it is gets collided each other, it again more friction takes place. Due to the collision, there is a due to the friction, large amount of charge gets generated. The generated charge we called is as a lightning and thunderstorm. Okay, as we are seeing in the sky, okay, which is releasing enormous amount of charge for a small amount of interval of time or small time, we will see. That is all happening by the friction. Okay, this is happening. Sir, how can you say that sir, glass rod only will get positive charge, am I right? Silk cloth only will get negative charge. Depends on its electron affinity, it is happening. We know that electron affinity from the properties of atomic structure when we are studying in chemistry. Okay, the electron affinity is nothing but the energy which accommodate, energy of the atom which accommodate the electrons inside the orbits. Okay, depends on the atomic bond, there is an accommodation energy will be developed, nothing but electron affinity. Depends on the electron affinity, some object will lose the electron, some object will gain the electron. Such a way one will become positive, other one will become negative. That was the basic origin for this friction. Now, after this friction, coming to the conduction property. What do you mean by conduction? Conduction. Simple. If you are keeping a charged body near to the kept contact with the uncharged body. When a charged body kept contact with the uncharged body, obviously charge transfers from the charged body to the uncharged body. Simply, a wire is flowing the current. When you are touching it, you will get shock, since our human body is also conductive. So you are getting the charge, in the sense the charge has transferred. Same way, when two wires, when you are joining charged body and uncharged body, automatically charged. Of course, there is charges flowing, I am not talking about that. If you take a normally any charged body, let us say this is a positively charged body, kept contact with uncharged body, this is a neutral body initially. But since it is positively charged, when you are keeping contact with the uncharged body, what happened? In neutral body, number of electrons equal to number of protons. But coming to here, in positive charge, number of electrons is less. Deficiency of electrons is there. Since it is having the deficiency of electron, from the first property, like charges, repel, unlike charges will attract. This positive charge try to attract negative charges from this body. Therefore, positive charges never moves. Nothing but protons never move out of the atom. Always electron causes for the conduction. Okay.